You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about how to automate custom vision model creation with AutoML for images. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about how to automate custom vision model creation with AutoML for images with Serge. Serge, how are you doing, my friend?
Hello, Seth. How are you?
Fantastic. So tell us who you are and what you do, bud.
Hello. So I am based in Paris, in France. I am Serge Retkowsky, working for Microsoft since 3 years now. And I am mainly working on AI projects, including computer vision.
That's fantastic. But you actually work on real world problems, not like the stuff that I kind of make up, right?
Yes, that's correct. So currently, many companies and organizations are using computer vision for multiple kind of projects like predictive maintenance, healthcare, security, retail, autonomous driving, and so on. So the good thing is for computer vision is that it's very easy with AutoML for images available with Azure Machine Learning to build and train some new models, to deploy this model into Azure, and then to quickly do some predictions based on images, because computer vision is not only analyzing content from database or database management system. You will analyze images, and images is just a collection of pixels, and it's very easy to build and train some deep neural network in order to help companies and organizations to take advantages of images or videos.
I mean, that's fantastic. So you're going to show it. You're going to talk about three real world scenarios. Can you describe them for us?
Yes, for sure. So let's take some examples. So the first examples I would like to share with you is how to use computer vision model for quality control. So quality control is key. Many companies and organizations are doing predictive maintenance, package inspection, product and component assembly, defect reduction, improving worker safety, and many additional things. So in this case, the first example will be about quality control, how to build and train a model, an object detection model with Azure Machine Learning and using AutoML for images. So I will quickly show you some examples. I have another example in the retail industry in order to count product from shelves. And the last example will be about how to detect fire from images and fire from a webcam, for example.
Awesome. Well, can we take a look?
Yes. So let's start with the first one. So as you can see, this is a Python notebook. I have previously built a custom vision model to detect quality control. So as you can see, sometimes there are quality control issues in this example. This is not correct. And on the right part, this is correct. The beauty of AutoML for images is that it will automatically choose for you the best custom vision model and the best hyperparameter tuning parameters directly using AutoML for images. So first, I tried to analyze a collection of images. I was able to run AutoML for images to build and train my model and then to deploy my model. And when your model is deployed, it's very easy to use it. So let's take a quick example. Okay, as you can see, this is just an image of a product. And as you can see, there is a gap here between these two blue pieces. So this is not correct according to this image. Let's have a look if our model is able to detect this. So I'm going to run live all the steps. And as you can see, yes, this is the first result. There is an issue with the package inspection. It says not correct with a confidence close to 80%, which is very good. And by the way, this is the location of the region where the computer vision model is analyzing the content. So what do you think?
That's cool. I mean, like looking at it, did you have to do much to get this to work? Or like, I see that the inference is happening, but how did you How did you build the model? Like, we talked about AutoML from images a couple of weeks ago. Is it just a question of giving it the images and letting it go?
Yes. So there was a dedicated AI show about AutoML for images. And the good thing is that with AutoML for images, you can do object detection problem, you can do image classification problem, instance segmentation as well. So what I previously did was to collect my images, to tag my images, and then with just a couple of lines like that one, I can do an object detection using AutoML for images, using, in this case, I am using YOLO version 5, which is very good for object detection.
Can you do me a favor? Press Control Plus a couple of times just to make the code a little bit bigger. Control Plus. There you go. And then if you scroll down, I see. Okay. I see. So basically, and I know we did a show on this, but seeing a real world case scenario is actually kind of cool. You basically tell it object detection, you're using YOLO V5, and you say go.
Yes, I just say go. Of course, it's always possible to add additional information, options, parameters. But just with a couple of lines, just say, okay, I want image in object detection, and I can pick up a framework like YOLO V5, and that's it. Yeah.
That's really, and how long did it take to train the right model? Is it like?
Oh, in this model, it was a question of 10 or 15 minutes, okay, based on 100 images, not so much. Okay, but it's a good starting point, and the quality of the model was quite very good based on my validation dataset.
And that's cool, because going from an idea to a prototype of machine learning in 15 minutes, I think is quite cool, if you ask me. All right, what's the next example?
Yes, it is quite cool. So as you can see, this is the results. And what you can do, it's always good to combine, for example, speech to text. If you want
the quality control prediction is not correct with a confidence of 79%.
So this is just the use of our speech to text capabilities. So you can play this audio file directly from the interface, or you can send a message to a Teams channel. So of course you can integrate Teams with Azure Machine Learning, and you can send a message to a Teams channel. Let's have a look. You will see there that the quality control prediction is not correct.
So now you're combining a bunch of cool AI things to alert people if there's something wrong. Because there might be a situation where it's imperative that someone get a message about whatever it is that's going on with the picture. And this is a cool way to do it.
That's correct. So the goal is in real time to send some alerts. So you can send emails if you want to, or just use a Teams notification, because with just a couple of lines, you can do it. Only when there is something wrong, in this case, when this is not correct.
That's cool. All right, what are the other examples? I know I jumped the gun, but this is really cool so far. What do you got?
So next example, it's about retail, okay? So we know that all the retailers have some issues with their products on the shelves, and they want to be able to detect if products are missing, for example, for the resupply. And this is another example. So it's still about an object detection custom vision model for that. Mm-hmm. But in this case, as you can see, I will be able to count the number of drinks. And I can say, okay, there is no more water, or there is too much sodas or whatever. And it's very easy to do. Let's go to the key part. So this is another a new image. Okay, that you can take from a camera or a webcam, for example. And let's run the model. And the model will say, okay, there is 18 drinks, Coca and fizzy water and 7-Up and whatever. Okay, and same thing, you can automatically count the number of products. And in this case, it will say, I need to resupply 6 drinks because some drinks are left. And same thing, I can send a message on my Teams channel, and I know that I can resupply some products.
Oh my goodness. This is really cool, because you can imagine a scenario where you literally have a camera pointed at the stock, and then every night it just checks, and it's like, hey, you know, you need to put another 7-Up in there or something. That's really cool.
That's it. That's pretty cool. Okay. There is not so much things to do except building a custom vision model to detect the brands. And then it's very easy with AutoML for images and all the great options there to create, to build and train and to deploy your model. And one thing, you can deploy your model on the edge, not only on the cloud, but you can deploy it on the edge directly into a webcam, for example, or CCTV.
Interesting. So the model that you build in AutoML for images, you can download and put it on any device that could run a model like that. Okay.
That's it.
That's cool. All right. What else you got for us, bud?
Okay. So next example is how to create and deploy your model on the edge. Let's say you have a CCTV and you want to be able to detect any new fire for fire detection. So same thing, I am using an image classification. I have built and trained a model using thousands of images of fire and non-fire. Mm-hmm. I was using as well AutoML for images from Azure Machine Learning. And then I deployed the model. And what we can do first is just to play a little bit with the model just to see if we can detect a fire. So this is an image from a fire. It was in Paris a couple of weeks ago. The good thing is that nobody was hurt. So that's great.
Thank you.
And this is, we can see a fire, obviously. And let's call the model just to check. And the model says, yes, there is a fire with 81%. Okay.
Wow.
So imagine that you build and train a model on a CCTV, on a webcam, and in real time, it will be able to detect a new fire. Okay.
Yeah.
And what you can do as well using integration with additional services is that, let's say you have a fire department address. Okay. So you can retrieve the latitude and longitude. So it's an address in Paris, as you can see. And this is the webcam location. The fire was in Place de l'Opéra in Paris. So you can retrieve as well latitude and longitude. And you can use Bing to collect information like the time for the fire department to go to the fireplace. And in this case, it will say, okay, usually it takes 13 minutes, but at the moment, we have a lot of traffic jams, and the additional travel time due to traffic will be 99 minutes. Wow. And the good thing is that you can send a message to the fire department. This is the map, so you can take this street and then go to Boulevard des Invalides and so on. And you can use the Bing integration in order to display in a map the location between the fireplace. Okay, so we have a lot of traffic in Place de l'Opéra at the moment, and this is the shortest destination in order for the fire department to go to the fireplace.
Wow.
So another example. What you can do, of course, is to analyze in real-time videos. Okay, let's have a look in this case. So let's play. Okay, so as you can see at the beginning of the video, there is no fire detected. Okay, and then after a couple of seconds, you can see a car who is currently burning. Okay, so let's try to analyze this video using our custom vision model. And I can run the process. It will analyze some frames. At the beginning, no fire was detected. And now, after this frame, there is an alert. And same thing, I can have a notification on my Teams channel. As you can see.
Wow.
Fire detected at frame 240, 270, and so on. So I have real-time alerts. And as you can see, yes, at the beginning from my CCTV, there was no fire with 78% of confidence. And after a certain period of time, 100% of fire. Yes, because obviously the model was not wrong at this time. And that's it. So another nice example about how to use a computer vision model in order to detect some specific events. It can be a car accident, it can be smoke detection, it can be fire detection, and you can run your model directly on the edge, directly on the video camera. So what do you think?
The thing I like about this the most, Serge, is that, I mean, I make AI models all the time, but I look at it from a clinical perspective. Like, is this model working? Is everything doing the right thing? I like the way, especially with the fire one, and obviously if fires are really sad, and if anyone had to go through it, super sad. But imagine a scenario where fire departments can be alerted immediately that there's a fire somewhere, and it tells them how to get there the fastest in the same instant. I think putting that all together is actually really cool. How did you come up with these scenarios, Serge?
It was just a curiosity. What is good with AI is that, of course, you can spend some time to build a model, but think about a full integration with any solution like a CCTV or like any specific equipment. What you want is not only to predict something like the fire or to do any kind of prediction. Maybe you want a little bit more. You want real-time notification, okay? And if you need to go from a place to another one, if you can have the shortest, path or route, that's nice. And the shortest will depend on the time of the day. It will depend on the traffic jam, and using integration with Bing, you can have everything included, the forecast, for example. So at the moment, there is no rain, mostly sunny, and you can have additional information. So you can create an end-to-end solution with a combination of multiple Azure services, and of course, including our custom vision model, which is key in this kind of application to detect a fire or any specific event.
I love it. So where can people go to find out more, my friend?
Sorry?
Where can people go to find out more about how to do this?
So if you want to learn a little bit more, of course, there is the official documentation from AutoML for Images. And I made a dedicated GitHub repo where you can find more than 30 Python notebooks. All of them are available for free, I mean. So if you want to evaluate AutoML for Images, you can use or leverage my demos notebook if you want to start evaluating AutoML for Images.
Awesome. Well, Serge, thank you so much. Everyone go check out those notebooks. They're really cool. Thank you so much for spending some time with us, my friend.
You're welcome.
You've been learning all about how to automate custom vision model creation with AutoML for Images with Serge. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.
Hopefully we'll see you next time. Take care.